we're just fine, and we probably pick up 8 to 10 yards. The last one was really just a miscommunication between what was going on. In retrospect, obviously in hindsight looking at it, I wish I'd have just ran the football, be done with it, and go in at halftime. So, you know, at that point in there, we got the ball back with, I think, a minute left. Our mindset has always been, and my mindset has always been, we got a minute. We've scored in less than that. We've done it in the past. We can do it here. But taking in all the factors and having the ability to look back on it now, obviously I would have probably changed what I had done and called and worked on.
Obviously you'd like to get back on track offensively this week, but what have you seen from North Carolina A&T's defense? It seems to be statistically really good.
It really is. I mean, they do a great job of stopping the run. They keep the box pretty heavy in a variety of different ways. Obviously, their first ball game, they blew out St. Augustine, I think 66 to nothing or something like that. I don't remember the exact score. And then last week, Kent State, who has got some talented players, really kept them in check throughout the game. So we've got to do a good job of being who we are and executing at a level that we need to execute. We're still going to run the football, but we've got to do a better job as far as our eye discipline and what we're reading. We've got to do a better job of running routes, and we've got to do a better job of catching the football. You know, there's a lot of things that we can get better at offensively, but the latter of those two or the latter three things there are things that we've got to really work on this week and get back to what we're doing. You know, everybody wants to point to Dane's interceptions or this and that, but there's a lot of plays in that game that could have changed the course of the game in a hurry. So he threw some good balls that should have been caught. We ran some routes that we should have hit. We ran some routes that were not where they needed to be. So there's a lot of things that we got to continue to keep going. But this, again, is not going to be the game that defines us for our season. No, I think we got some young guys still. I mean, there's a perception that you know, we have, you know, all these receivers have got a ton of experience, and they really don't. Josh has got a lot of experience. You know, Keevan's got experience, and Hobbs has a little bit. You know, Nigel and Bishop and some others that have got to step in and play don't have the type of experience coming into the season that those other three of the other two do. You know, you're going to have some growing pains as you go through that part of it. You know, as much as we miss Kiaris, and he's got, those are huge shoes to fill, we miss, you know, Connor just as much, because Connor's that guy that runs great routes, that's where he's supposed to be, that's catching the football, that's the doing the little things. As I like to say, you know, he's the handyman. You know, he's around fixing everything. And so you got to have that guy that's going to do that part of it too. And so our guys are unselfish about what's going on. They're not sitting here saying, I want the ball more or this or that. We just got to do a better job of executing.
Coach, what were the positives, I guess, that you took away most from the game, especially the first quarter?
Well, you know, obviously you got to start defensively. I thought we played outstanding. You know, like I said, that's the best I've seen us play defensively since I've been here, and against a really, really good football team that's explosive. Thought we did a great job of stopping the run, keeping JT contained as well as you can keep him contained, and putting pressure on the quarterback and not letting him feel comfortable in the pocket to be able to sit back there all day and pick you apart. So I thought we did great there. You know, early in the game, I thought our tempo was at a rate that I wanted it to be at. With that being said, I think we ran the football well early in certain situations. You know, we had a couple of good schemes. I thought we did a good job from that standpoint in the run game and in some of our third and long situations that we got in. The thing that we've got to continue to do a better job is, especially in the second half with weather conditions and all the things that were going on, we've got to do a better job of being more consistent on first down, because we got in way too many third down and long situations.
Last
Yeah, you know, I think it was, you know, guys just did an outstanding work during spring. I think our coaching staff, Coach Young, Coach Norwood leading that group, but our staff in general has done a good job of getting guys coached up and understanding what we're trying to accomplish, and guys playing with the sense of, I do my job, I'm trusting him to do his job. When we do that, we as a unit play really well. You're not trying to do too much. You're staying within what you've got to do and your responsibility. And when you do that and trigger and play fast, good things happen. I think some of the personnel moves that we've made, especially up front, I think, you know, really Jerry Uden Hayden has done a great job interiorly for our defense, stopping the run and giving, providing pass rush and push. Jeremy Smith moving over to the strong side, I think that's really helped him. He had a big sack last week and was a step away from having a couple more. And then, you know, Brubaker was, he and Jeremy were kind of switching in and out the first week. We moved Brubaker over to the Leo last week, and I thought he played outstanding over there. I mean, just has done a great job of, he's lost a little weight. He's been good in the weight room. His quickness is there. He's a very intelligent football player. And so those four guys playing well up front has allowed our linebackers to really be able to key and trigger and play at the rate they need to play at. So, you know, obviously I'm extremely pleased with where they're at, and but knowing that we can still get better, you know.
I don't know if you're a fan of the term trap game or not, but where this falls on the schedule, and taking nothing away from A&T, but after Ohio State, before you hit the road for Fresno State, would this qualify in your mind as
term? You know, I'm not going to use that term because of the quality of opponent that's coming in here. I mean, they were 10-2 last year, you know, and playing in a bowl game and won it. And so they're a very, very good football team. Anytime you have a loss, the best thing you can do is get back on the practice field and go back to work and put that one away, learn from it, move on, and be prepared for next week. And, you know, our motto around here has always been, you know, after that play, we're moving on to the next play, the next quarter, the next game. We've got to continue to keep striving forward and pushing together.
And then real quick, you mentioned the weather delay. How did you, I mean, that's the first time you've had a 60-minute weather delay as a head coach. How did you?
Yeah, I thought our football team handled it well. You know, obviously we've been in delayed situations before. We've actually had to deal with it during fall camp. So our guys were accustomed to it. We went in, explain to them exactly what's going on. You know, I'll let you know as soon as I know something. When they start adding more time, you just go back in, you talk about it. But the biggest thing for us, you know, being on the road, you're drenched. So whatever little bit of clothing that you can change, whether it's socks or whatever, trying to get those things changed out, get down, rest, you know, get you something to eat, because you don't know how long this is going to last. You got to think, you know, we're having our pregame meal 3 hours or something prior to the game. So you got to get some fuel back in them. And then when you go back out, get them back focused in on what we got to do. And it gives us time in, at the halftime to be able to make some adjustments, talk through some things, and make sure that we're still on page.
You won't see athletes like Ohio State's got the rest of the year, so the challenge will be different. But what do you hope your offense maybe takes from Saturday and learns from? What kind of lessons do you think can be learned?
You know, two things on that question. I don't know that I completely agree with not seeing those type of athletes, because I think there's some really, really good athletes in our conference. I mean, you look at Houston, beating OU, you know, just 2 weeks ago, they got athletes. You look at East Carolina last week, upsetting North Carolina State. You know, our conference has got athletes, in my opinion, top to bottom, and I think the coaching in our league is really, really strong. With that being said, what we have to take from it offensively is we got to be us. We got to execute at a high rate. We've got to be able to make plays when our name's called. And we got to continue to keep pushing the envelope on the things that we're doing and keep progressing each and every week. You can't go into a game expecting something to happen. You've got to go in and make something happen. And that's what we've got to do a better job of.